I am surprised that you suggest these reforms while you are yet prisoners on this island and in Kuo Yu's power. That these things should be done, there is no doubt. But just now a dreadful war is likely to break out, and frightful things may happen to us all. Our queen has such conceit that she thinks she can overcome the Sudik and his people, but it is said Sudik's magic is very powerful, although not as great as that possessed by his wife, Rora, before Kuo Yu transformed her into a golden pig. I don't blame her very much for doing that, remarked Dorothy, for the Flatheads were wicked to try to catch your beautiful fish, and the witch Rora wanted to poison all the fishes in the lake. Do you know the reason? Asked the Lady Aurex. I don't suppose there was any reason except just wickedness, replied Dorothy. Tell us the reason, said Ozma earnestly. Well, Your Majesty, once, a long time ago, the Flatheads and the Skeezers were friendly. They visited our island, and we visited their mountain, and everything was pleasant between the two peoples. At that time the Flatheads were ruled by three adepts in sorcery, beautiful girls who were not Flatheads, but had wandered to the Flat Mountain and made their home there. These three adepts used their magic only for good, and the mountain people gladly made them their rulers. They taught the Flatheads how to use their canned brains, and how to work metals into clothing that would never wear out, and many other things that added to their happiness and content. Kuo Yu was our queen then, as now, but she knew no magic, and so had nothing to be proud of. But the three adepts were very kind to Kuo Yu. They built for us this wonderful dome of glass, and our houses of marble, and taught us to make beautiful clothing and many other things.